Hello student, today's topic is electric current. What is electric current? To understand this better, just have a look at this picture. Here ACB is a metallic wire and we are connecting the two end points with this cell. And before connecting the two end points of this wire with this cell, the electrons which are present in this metal moves in different direction. And after connecting with this cell, electrons will move in one direction. Student, as you know, in our surroundings, there are some substances and metals which can produce free electrons, and free electrons are present in the outermost shell of the atoms, and only free electrons produce electricity. That means free electrons are capable to carry electrical charge. There are some metals like copper, silver and iron. They are good conductors of electricity because they can produce free electrons. So in this picture we can see electrons at this point B gets required charge from this cell, and after getting charge, electrons are in motion. So a motion of electrons in one part of the wire causes the neighboring electrons to move. So in this manner, motion is related to all other electrons of the wire, and all electrons along the length of the wire are drifted. So that means electrons, free electrons will move from point B to point C, and after point C to move point A, and after reaching point A, electrons enter into chemical cell, and the chemical reaction of these cells drive these free electrons and they again re-enter at point B. So in this way, free electrons are produce charge in this wire. But student, an electric current can also be a flow of positive charge, and by convention the direction of current is taken as the direction of flow of positive charges. Thus the direction of current is opposite to the direction of flow of negative charges. So how we measure this electric current? So student, as you know, electric current is the rate of flow of charge. Electric current is the rate of flow of electric charge. So here rate means time. So we can write electric current equal to charge flowing upon time. So if we represent electric current with I, then what will be the equation? So I equal to charge flowing, I am representing charge flowing with Q and time by T. So I will be I equal to Q upon T. So student, the SI unit of electric current is ampere, and SI unit of charge flowing is coulomb, and ampere is denoted by capital letter A, whereas coulomb is denoted by capital letter C. So now student, you have to find out the total charge. which flows through this wire. So here again I am writing I equal to Q by T. So how you will calculate the total charge of this wire? So let us assume n electrons, n electrons are crossing a point in a conductor. So n electrons are passing a point in a conductor. So we can write I equal to Q equal to n, and the charge of electrons E. So in place of Q we will write n E and time, then n, and the charge of electrons is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 upon T. So we can, as we know the SI unit of electric current is ampere, so we can write here 1A equal to 1 coulomb and time by second, 1 second. So what will be the definition of 1 ampere? The electric current flowing through a conductor is 1 ampere. If a charge of 1 coulomb passes through a point of the conductor in 1 second. So here we can write electric current flowing through a conductor will be 1 ampere if a charge of one coulomb passes through a point in the conductor, and the electric current flowing through a conductor is measured with a device which is called ammeter.